Enhanced community quarantine has led to a new normal when it comes to the movement of people in Luzon. The strict implementation of lockdown measures has led to disagreements and even clashes between citizens and security forces. So what can people do or not do during the current lockdown period? We'll discuss this with lawyer Domingo Cayosa, the president of the Integrated Bar of the Philippines. Attorney Cayosa, good afternoon to you. I'm Tony Velasquez with Nikki De Guzman.
Good afternoon, Tony and Nikki, and good afternoon to the ANC televiewers.
Well, thank you for joining us on our program. Well, let's begin first, with the consistency with which law enforcers are trying to implement the quarantine protocols in areas where they're assigned. You've discussed in a previous interview that you seem to notice how law enforcers are taking, their own initiative to interpret how quarantine protocols or discipline should be enforced among residents.
Yeah, by and large, the law enforcers and the local government officials are trying their best to enforce the protocols of the ECQ. Unfortunately, however, there are incidents caught in media, social media and mass media, that shows in different places, in different times, under different circumstances, the law enforcers interpret and apply the law differently. Mm. And unfortunately, this causes problems insofar as the citizenry is concerned. They are confused. And at the end of the day, it also affects their willingness to comply with the law. Of course, as lawyers, we encourage everybody to just simply obey and cooperate with the authorities. Mm-hmm. At the same time, also, we ask the authorities to please be clear about the laws and the instructions and be equal about its implementation. Mm-hmm. Even in a crisis like this, Tony, the rule of law must prevail. It cannot be left to the whims or personal preferences or interpretation of local officials or specific law enforcers.
Yeah.
There must be clarity, regularity, and consistency.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's talk about specific incidents. Of course, one of the most controversial one being the fatal shooting of a retired Army soldier in Quezon City. When a police officer challenges a person who is seen or believed to be violating quarantine protocols, what should a police officer do with that person?
Under existing rules, the police officer or any law enforcer can use reasonable force to enforce to effect an arrest or to enforce compliance with an existing law. In this particular case, unfortunately, it appears that there was a miscalculation on the part of the police officer. And even if you look at the details of the terms of engagement of police officers, they have their internal rules on these specific situations. It seems that he has failed, or perhaps because of the tense situation, he committed a mistake. And that's why is now facing criminal charges. It is very unfortunate, but on one hand, it is also good that the proper charges have been filed so that the police officer will also be given the opportunity to explain himself and to defend himself before a court of law, not through social media or not trial by publicity, but at least now the DOJ has done its part. The prosecutors have charged him, and he has to explain himself before an impartial judge.
Yeah. But because people are saying it, the situation would not have escalated if, say, for example, if the victim here, Corporal Ragos, had not, become verbally violent against the police officers who confronted him. So would that also be, in your view, a reminder to citizens that they should not become, openly confrontational with law enforcers who are reminding them of quarantine protocols?
That is true. Ordinarily, the ordinary citizen should respect and obey the authorities. is expected and demanded of every citizen. It is not good conduct, it is not good citizenship for us to question everything that the police officers do. You know, these guys have been there 24/7. They're tired. They've been one of our frontliners. And to exacerbate the situation by confronting them, maligning them, questioning them, or even challenging them can lead to tragic consequences as what has happened to Sergeant Ragos. But unfortunately, it now appears that Sergeant Ragos was not of sound mind.
Yeah.
He had some mental problems, and that's perhaps the reason why he did those terrible things. And there was a miscalculation on the part of the officer. But our call for the ordinary citizens is, please, these are rules and regulations meant to protect all of us. The first order of the day really is for us to cooperate and comply with the requirements of the protocol and obey the laws set by duly constituted authorities.
Well, obviously, you know, the police, when they chanced upon Corporal Ragos, did in fact try to remind the soldier that he was in violation of quarantine protocols because he was out in public. He may not have been wearing a mask at the time. But what happens when the police enter a gated subdivision, as with the case of this Spanish citizen residing in an exclusive village, where the police actually accosted the maid who was just standing within the foreigner's premises? And also reminded that she was violating quarantine protocols. Do they actually have a right to argue with the police about it?
Well, the constitutional right to freedom of expression does not disappear because we have a crisis or we have a health emergency. So everybody is free to argue, but it has to be done in a proper manner. In this particular, quite different from the Ragos case, because in this case, there was nothing wrong with the Spanish citizen. And then the police were invited by the local officials to please to help enforce the regulations inside the gated subdivision. So the police had the right to be there. They were invited by the barangay officials to assist them. And from what we've seen so far, so many versions of the video, it appears that the foreigner was reacting very badly to the courteous confrontation by the police. It appears that he has gone way out of line, prompting and forcing the policemen to try to arrest him. So it's a totally different case. There's no allegation that the foreigner was not of sound mind. The only complaint he had was that he had a back injury. That's it.
Because there are some people who would say that if you're within the premises of your own
officer who was politely confronting him and the maid.
I'm sorry. I spoke over you, Attorney Cayosa. But you know, some people have this view that if a person was within the premises of his own domicile, then you know the police should not be called in to actually enforce any quarantine protocol because you're already inside your own house.
Well, in this particular case, it's clear that he was not the first. The maid was not in the house. She was watering the plants by the sidewalk. And the sidewalk is already outside the fence or the private property of the resident. And it's a street. It's a public place. It may be privately owned by the association, but it's a public place. And our understanding in the letter and spirit of the regulations and the ordinances pertaining to the matter of wearing of face masks, what is prescribed is that if you go to public places, get out of the confines of your private residence or your office, you wear a mask. So the maid was required to wear a mask, and that is what she was told. It was just a simple thing of reminding the maid to wear a mask, but unfortunately, Mr. Parra took it out of context, and one thing led to the other.
Well, if in this case, as you did point out, that the police only responded to a call by, I guess, officials of the village who wanted them to actually remind the Parra household of the quarantine protocols, Do you feel that citizens today do have that responsibility to call in the authorities if they actually observe somebody else, like a neighbor or some bystander who is not following quarantine or proper, you know, anti-COVID precautions?
First, it was the barangay captain of the village that requested the police presence. So that was part of her job, a part of his authority. Now, for ordinary citizen, it may not be our legal duty to call the police and to report crimes or violations of ordinances, but certainly it can be our civic duty. And there's nothing wrong for citizens to alert the police on crimes being committed or violations of ordinances happening in their respective places. Mm.
Well, I remember, you know, other, you know, quarantine violators who've been apprehended by authorities. Some of them were made to squat under the sun, although some were just made to watch a COVID-19 instructional video. But there are others who are a little bit more extreme. Some of them were kept in dog cages. And, you know, the disparity and the severity of how other authorities are enforcing quarantine protocols, you know, how do you feel about that?
Well, it may appear initially as creative, inventive, and very resourceful on the part of local officials or law enforcers. But it concerns us because, one, if there is no uniformity or the penalties being imposed vary greatly, then our people get confused. Secondly, if the application of the law is selective, meaning to say, you know, if you're poor, you get thrown into prison or arrested. If you're not poor or you're of consequence, they let go of you. Or, as you say, it could be as innocent as a Zumba dance or watching COVID info video. And it can be absurd and cruel as putting somebody in a dog cage or, in the case of Ragos, being fatally shot. Mm. So we remind the law enforcers that the Constitution, Section 19 of the Bill of Rights, says that no cruel, degrading, or inhuman punishment may be inflicted by anyone on anyone. Mm. So we call on the local government officials, the law enforcers, to please bear this in mind, and we ask that government clarifies and makes more or less reasonable the penalties that they would impose on violators, and that the law be equally applied regardless of your status. Mm.
And do you feel, Attorney Cayosa, that the Philippine National Police does in fact keep an open ear to any of the suggestions that your organization makes?
Yes, as a matter of fact, we coordinate with the Philippine National Police. For instance, just today, the Quezon City chapter of IDP turned over to the PNP so many thousands of posters reminding and warning our countrymen that it is illegal to discriminate against or attack COVID patients and frontliners. So mm-hmm. we actually work with law enforcers. We work with government because the rule of law calls for cooperation among different sectors, especially for us lawyers. They listen to us. We give them advice. But at the same time also, if there are shortcuts or there are violations of the rights of citizens, then IBP also takes it upon itself to remind our law enforcers that they must operate within the confines of the law. The rule of law must be maintained. Due process must be maintained. They cannot be the lawmakers, the enforcers, the prosecutors, and the judges.
And maybe shifting to just a different topic, you know, before we wrap up, of course, we don't see the courts opening just yet while the enhanced community quarantine is still in effect. But there are already, you know, suggestions that even court hearings could be held through, you know, teleconferencing or video conferencing. Cases could still be filed through e-filing. How do you feel about that kind of system still being done even after the quarantine is lifted?
Yes, first, a slight correction. Though the courts are not physically open, the reality is there are judges on duty, okay, and prosecutors in duty, and power lawyers on duty. And in extreme and pressing cases, they receive the pleadings and decide on issues electronically. Mm-hmm. Now, going beyond COVID-19, IDT, together with some law firms and our lawyer leaders all over the country, in consultation with the academicians, we are proposing the use of technology to simplify and to expedite the legal processes and the court processes, because it is clear that our justice system is so much delayed, very slow, and we believe that making use of technology like teleconferencing, like online courts, or doing things through email will actually hasten, because justice delayed is really justice denied. So we hope that one thing good out of this COVID-19 emergency is our realization that we can actually do much more, better and faster by using technology.
Absolutely. If we look at how this pandemic has changed the ordinary course of the work that we have come to expect as routinary, that somehow the changes in the workflow and the work style can somehow be adapted to our normal routines even after this pandemic may be, you know, already resolved. Attorney Cayosa, thank you very much for speaking with us on ANC, and we hope that you and your loved ones will keep safe.
Well, thank you very much. Let's keep safe and help others.
Thank you, sir.